Giordano.
About him being glorified, we go low, he goes high, because he is the Most High God. Today on 5 to 5, we are talking about things we take for granted. You know, I just came into work today, and we're just having a discussion with my sister Melissa and our technical manager Theophilus, and we're just talking about how people sometimes, as believers, as even human beings, we take things for granted. And I remember also a man, he just came in to give his testimony regarding how he was saved, you know, from an almost accident today. And sometimes we take these things for granted. We think, you know, it's my right. It's normal. It's something that has to automatically happen. And what we don't realize, it's all by the grace of God.
This is 5 to 5 on Route 104.
Yeah, we're talking about things we sometimes take for granted. I'm sure maybe not all of us take these things for granted. Some people are quick enough to realize, you know, this is the hand of God. This is the doing of God. This is the grace of God. But sometimes we make it a normal thing, you know. For example, number one, waking up every day. The fact that you have seen a new day, the fact that you are able to rise up from your bed and go about your hassles, go about your work or whatever it is that you do, you know, just the very fact that you've woken up in the morning, you know, that's something that looks so, you know, it looks like a very normal thing. It looks like, you know, ni kawaida, I have to wake up. But the thing is, that is something we take for granted. And the word of God says, this is the day that I have made, and I will rejoice. You know, God is calling us to rejoice in the day, because it's not to be taken for granted, the fact that you've seen a new day. So I think this is something we need to be serious about, choosing to rejoice in a new day, because it's not your right. It's not a lazima that you wake up.
5 to 5 on Route 104.
We're talking about things that we sometimes take for granted and forget that it has taken the grace of God. Number two, good health. You know, if you're listening to me right now and you're in perfect health, everything about you is intact. You can, you know, just shake yourself a bit and feel like, you know, I'm fine. I'm doing well. Good health. Health is wealth. That is so true. You need to thank God every single day for good health.
5 to 5 on Route 104.
We're talking about things that we sometimes take for granted. Number three, when you move from one point to another point and you are safe. You know, you wake up in the morning, and because it's a day for you to maybe go to work or carry out your various projects, that will entail you moving from your house to another house, or from your house to another institution or to another place. So you moving from point A to B, and you being able to go back to point A, and that is back to your home, back to your family in one piece. That is something that you need to be grateful to God for.
5 to 5 on Route 104.
We're talking about things we sometimes take for granted as believers and not realize that, you know, it has taken the grace and the hand of God. Number four, freedom to worship. Freedom of worship, you know, freedom to worship, freedom of worship, whatever the word I'm supposed to use there. But the point that you're able, the very fact that you're able to worship God freely, especially as a country, the fact that you're able to express yourself in worship, you're able to go to church without fear, you're able to attend fellowship and talk about God without fear. Nobody is coming, no guns are pointed at you. It's not a crime that you can worship God. That is something we need to be grateful to God for.
5 to 5 on Route 104.
We're talking about things that we sometimes take for granted, things that we don't understand or forget that it is by the grace of God. And number five, the very fact that you're able to fellowship. The fact that you are able to move from your house and go and fellowship in a certain place, the very fact that you have access to the Word of God, you can carry your Bible freely, you can read your Bible in the bus. You know, the fact that you're able, you know, to say, I will read the Word today, and you're able to do it. Sometimes we're like, I will pray tomorrow, or sometimes I will thank God tomorrow, I will do this later. You know, postponing fellowship with God. but not knowing that, you know, that is the grace is sufficient at that point for you to, you know, fellowship in the word of God and fellowship even together with brethren. Sometimes we take this for granted. We're like, I'm going to do it tomorrow. And you keep postponing the things of God, not knowing that, you know, God is calling you into fellowship because his grace is continually sufficient for you.
5 to 5 on Route 104.
We need not to take anything for granted. We need not to forget the grace of God. We need not to think that these things are normal. It is the hand of God. It is the gracious hand of God.
Hope FM. It's now 5 p.m.